This is Mato. Welcome to my online chess lecture. In this video, I will show you a game between Karl Schlechter and David Janowski. This very instructive chess game was played in Germany in 1898. Karl Schlechter had white pieces and he started with d4. David Janowski played d5, c4, queen's gambit, e6, queen's gambit, declined, knight to c3, knight to f6, knight to f3, and now c5, the Tarash defense, semi-Tarash. C takes on d5, e takes on d5, bishop to g5, pinning the knight, bishop to e6, d takes on c5, bishop takes on c5, and black has an isolated queen's pawn. e3, Janowski castled kingside, bishop to d3, knight to c6, and Schlechter castled kingside too. Queen to e7, white to move. Schlechter wants to bring his queen to the kingside, and he played queen to a4, intending queen to h4, h6. If something like a6, then queen to h4 is very unpleasant. Back to our game. So after queen to a4, we have h6, asking a question. Bishop to h4, keeping the pin. Rook from f to d8. Rook from a to c1. Bishop to b6, black is holding the ground. Schlechter goes for maneuvering to improve the position of his pieces. Knight to e2. Intending knight from e to d4, putting the pressure on the knight on c6. Bishop to d7. It is becoming tense. Schlechter goes for this daring move, queen to f4, daring black to play g5. Janowski played rook from a to c8. Of course, Janowski considered g5 and didn't like this continuation. After g5, knight takes on g5. And after h takes on g5, queen takes on g5, check, king to f8, queen to h6, check, king to e8, bishop takes on f6, and white is winning. And let's go back. In this position, after knight takes on g5, if knight to h5 is played, attacking white queen, then queen to f3, and after pawn takes knight, queen takes on h5, g takes on h4, queen to h7, check, king to f8, queen to h8, check, mate. Back to our game. So Janowski did the right thing by playing rook from a to c8, knight from e to d4, and now king to f8. This was the sign that black is playing g5. Should white move the queen or the bishop to a safe spot? What would you do? Schlechter played knight to f5, attacking the queen. Queen to e6. Let's take it back. If instead the bishop takes on f5, then bishop takes on f5, and after rook to b8, white can play bishop to d3 or rook from f to d1. With every exchange, the pawn on d5 will become weaker. Back to our game. In this position, queen to e6 was played. Black is playing g5, winning a piece. Queen to g3, threatening queen takes on g7, check, and now comes g5. This move is winning a piece at a cost. What is the cost for black? Two pawns plus exposing his king. But what is the alternative? It is white to move. What is better, bishop takes on g5 or knight takes on g5? Schlechter played knight takes on g5, keeping the bishop. If bishop takes on g5, then h takes on g5, queen takes on g5, knight to e8, and black is holding. White is still slightly better. Back to our game. Knight takes on g5. Schlechter wisely keeps the bishop. You will see the difference. Pawn takes knight. Bishop takes on g5. Knight to h5. Queen to h4. Queen to g6. White to move. In this position, Schlechter came up with a clever plan, but let's not pause yet. First move, bishop to h6 check, king to g8. White to move. What would you do now? Please suppose and find the best move for white. Did you pause? You didn't pause. Okay, never mind. I will give you a tip. Let's do it together. White knight on f5 would love to jump to e7, but that square is defended by the knight on c6. Does this give you a clue? Schlechter played rook takes knight. This is the winning move. Let's take it back. Knight to e7 check is also winning, like this. But the move played in the game is even more elegant. So we have rook takes on c6. In this position, black could have resigned. Bishop takes on f5 was played. If bishop takes on c6, then knight to e7 check. And after king to h8, bishop takes on g6, white is winning. Back to our game. So, Janowski played bishop takes on f5. Rook takes on g6, check. Bishop takes on g6, bishop takes on g6, f takes on g6, g4, knight to g7, queen to f6, knight to e8, attacking the queen. White played a move and black resigned, and the move is queen takes on g6, check. Janowski resigned. For the entertainment purpose, I will show you just one line. Black king must move to a safe spot, and the only safe spot is on h8, so king to h8, bishop to f4, bishop to c7, perhaps queen to h6, check, king to g8, queen to e6, check, king to g7, rook to c1. What now? Black even can't make a good move. If something like a6, then queen to e7, check, king to g8, bishop takes on c7, knight takes on c7, rook takes on c7, rook takes rook, queen takes rook, check, king to g7, queen takes on c7. This is just my line. I'm sure that Schlechter would do even better than that. What do you think of this game? And that is all. I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. I wish you good luck with your chess, and bye for now.